For over 300 years, the coastlines of England were at the mercy of Barbary pirates from the coast of North Africa, who attacked and plundered the English Channel, Ireland, Scotland, and Iceland, capturing over 1 million British men and women into slavery in North Africa. By the early 17th century, the situation was so bad that an entry in the calendar of state papers in May 1625 stated, "The Turks are upon our coasts. They take ships, only to take the men to make slaves of them." Did Africans really enslave Europeans? How did it happen? For the next 5 minutes, we will provide you further details of what really happened on 5 Minute Infographics. When were Europeans enslaved? The earliest contact with the pirates was in the Elizabethan period, when British explorers and merchants first ventured into the Mediterranean. They were attacked and seized by the pirates, who sold the crew into slavery and demanded ransoms for the merchants. In the first half of the 1600s, the Barbary pirates, coming from what is now Algiers and other ports in North Africa, were authorized by their governments to attack the shipping of Christian countries, where they grabbed ships and sold the sailors into slavery. Admiralty records show that during this time, the pirates plundered British shipping pretty much at will. As 18th century historian Joseph Morgan put it, this I take to be the time when those corsairs were in their zenith. A new study suggests that 1 million or more European Christians were enslaved by Muslims in North Africa between 1530 and 1780. A dissertation, Barbary Pirates, British Slaves, and the Early Modern Atlantic World, 1570 to 1800, by Catherine M. Steyer, University of Pennsylvania, considers the enslavement of Britons in the Barbary states between 1570 and 1800, and re-evaluates the demographics of the problem, concluding that more than 26,000 were enslaved, whereas few of those were redeemed. What was the level of enslavement? The attacks threatened England's fishing industry, with fishermen reluctant to put to sea. Sir John Elliot, Vice Admiral of Devon, declared that the seas around England seemed theirs. The situation was so bad that a committee for Algiers was set up by Parliament to oversee the ransoming of captives. In 1646, Parliament sent Edmund Caston to Algiers to negotiate the ransom and release of English captives, paying an average of £30 per man, and managed to free some 250 people before he ran out of money. Oliver Cromwell decided to take action and decreed that any captured pirates should be taken to Bristol and slowly drowned. Such was the extent of the Barbary terror that parish churches in Spain and Italy kept locked collection boxes marked for the poor slaves. England even set aside an Algerian duty from customs income to finance redemptions. Even Americans were not immune. One American slave reported that 130 other American seamen had been enslaved by the Algerians in the Mediterranean and Atlantic just between 1785 and 1793. What work did the slaves perform? The kidnapped, comprising public and private slaves, were sent to the slave markets of the Ottoman Empire to be bought as laborers, concubines, or pressed into the galleys, where they would man the oars. The public slaves were used to row the galleys in the pursuit of loot, working so strenuously that thousands died or went mad while chained to the oar. The private slaves worked as agricultural laborers, construction workers, or sold water around town for their owners. As they aged, or their owners' fortunes changed, slaves were resold. Many slaves converted to Islam, though, as Morgan put it, this only meant they were freed from the oar, though not from their patron's service. Christian women who had been taken as concubines often turned Turk to stay with their children, who were raised as Muslims. How many slaves were taken? In a new book, Robert Davis, professor of history at Ohio State University, calculated that between 1 million and 1.25 million Europeans were captured from the 16th to 18th centuries. Much of what has been written gives the impression that there were not many slaves and minimizes the impact that slavery had on Europe. Davis said, "How did Europe respond?" The European nations responded by attacking the pirates in their home bases. Algiers was frequently attacked by the British, French, and Spanish, and in the early 19th century, the United States. A British-led attack in 1816 led to the release of more than 4,000 slaves, and the power of the Barbary pirates was finally destroyed by European sea power. What do you think of the European enslavement? Share your comments below. Follow our Facebook page and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more stories about extraordinary people, places, and events. Thanks for sharing your fives with us.